here we go in our next toolkit entry for Chapter 7. This one is called Parallelogram and Kite Properties. So we're going to be talking about two different polygons here. The first of which is the parallelogram. By definition, it's a quadrilateral. That means four sides with two pairs of parallel sides. So go ahead and draw this picture right here in your notebook. And these are our two pairs of parallel sides here. And as the first one says here, we have the property that the opposite sides are parallel, as it looks like in the picture, but also not only are they parallel, but they're congruent. So for instance, let's say this side is 6 centimeters, so is this side, or let's say this is 14 centimeters, this would be 14 centimeters as well. So the opposite sides are not only parallel, but also congruent. Also, the next property is that opposite angles are congruent. So that means these angles are congruent. And then likewise, these two angles, because they're opposite as well, these two would be congruent also. So for instance, let's say this angle is 100 degrees. This one must be 100 degrees also. If this angle, this would have to be 80 down here, and this would have to be 80 down here. So we have opposites are congruent. Also, consecutive angles are supplementary. Consecutive means in a row, or ones that are next to each other here. So we've got these two angles here are in a row, they're consecutive, and they add up to be 180. These two angles here are consecutive. They also have a sum of 180 degrees. So are these, and so are these. So that's true for any parallelogram. Finally, the last one is that each diagonal bisects the other. So for instance here, if I were to go ahead and draw in those diagonals, it would look something like this. Here's one diagonal. Here's the other diagonal. And let's say I labeled the pointer. Let's say it's called as A, B, C, and D. And let's say this little point here right in the middle was E. So let's say I told you that from A to C, it is 14 centimeters. How far would it be from A to E? Well, these diagonals bisect each other, which means that whatever AC is, AE is going to be half of that. So it's going to be 7 centimeters. So that's each diagonal bisects the other diagonal. So that is the first figure we're dealing with here. The second figure is going to be kite. And a kite is a quadrilateral, going for a definition here first, a kite is a quadrilateral with two pairs of consecutive congruent sides. So here's a pair of consecutive congruent sides, and here's another pair. So for instance, I'm just making up sides again. Let's say this is 5 centimeters. This is 5 centimeters also. Maybe this is 10 centimeters, and this is 10. So we've got two pairs of consecutive congruent sides here. Now, as it turns out, if you were to draw a diagonal that was to go connecting where the two the pairs of consecutive sides that are congruent are together. If you were to connect this one here, so it connects these two points here where the congruent sides meet, it actually creates congruent triangles. So we have a left side and a right side, and these are two congruent triangles. And the reason why is we could prove it with, right now we have two sides. This is a shared side, so these are congruent triangles here. So what that means is that when we have congruent triangles, we can say some things about that. First of all, only one diagonal, and that's the diagonal right here, bisects the opposite angle. So in other words, whatever measurement this entire angle is, so let's say this entire angle happens to be 80 degrees altogether, it means this little angle here would have to be 40 degrees, and this little angle here would have to be 40 degrees also, because it's going to cut in half. Likewise over here too, it would be bisecting that angle as well. Also, one diagonal bisects the other diagonal, and this is only true in one case here. So if I were to draw another one here, this time I'll make a dotted blue line. Here's another diagonal right here. What happens is the original diagonal we have going here actually cuts the dotted blue one in half. So if the entire distance all the way across is, say, 12 centimeters, so let's say this is point A, and this is B, and C, and D, if we were to say AC equals 20 millimeters, therefore, here in the middle, let's call that point E here, we could say AE would have to be 10 millimeters. But keep in mind, it only cuts the blue dotted one in half. It only bisects that one. It does not bisect BD. Finally, last but not least here, we have the diagonals are perpendicular. So what happens here is, here's our two diagonals. It creates perpendicular means 90 degrees. So that's 90 degree angles. Here's what perpendicular means. So once again, 90 degree angle. This is a 90 degree angle, and so are the rest there. All right, so there's all you need to know about parallelograms and kites.